Well, I got a TV advantage, but it's against Skaven, who've got who have a wizard, which might actually be worse playing against Skaven. Well, not a natural one turner, but a movement 10. So he's only got 11 players. So this is the kind of matchup that I wanted. It's obviously not great that he does have a movement 10 gutter runner. He does have 4 cheerleaders though. 1-4, lost 4. And what are we on? 13-6-2. So this is game, what, 22 for 10 Talica. So hopefully. His journeyman takes him out. Oh my god. All right, it's a great matchup then. It's actually a great matchup. He was 10k short of a wizard. Unbelievable, Jeff. All right, it's a horrific matchup. That changes it from if he had just not had one of those coaches or cheerleaders, then it's just absolutely killed him, hasn't it? I wouldn't say he's got no chance, but that 10k difference, if he had 10k in the bank, it's unbelievable, isn't it? What an unbelievable difference. 140 TV up is the absolute dream. Absolute dream being 140k up. Now, Padu Babes could be pretty relevant for him, to be fair. But holy shit, it's not a wizard, isn't it? That's the important thing, it's not a wizard. Holy shit, that makes the game about 100 times easier, not having a wizard, without even exaggerating. Probably it makes it like 3 or 4 times easier. Hello, VIP Squirrel Dude. Sorry for not interacting with chat, but you know, I am tryharding, and will continue to do so, though, without Fash, unfortunately. Cheers. The reason for kicking there is obviously because he's got the one turn. So this is to negate the one turn, hopefully to one grind him. I'll speak a little bit, but what a terrible play putting him there instead of there. If he put him here, he totally shuts down this, doesn't he? But now it's just a dodge to three dice. And if he put that there, it would have totally shut it down, or at least made it ridiculously difficult. And he just didn't. Unbelievable, Jeff. Two TZs, that's about the best it's going to get for me, isn't it? Maybe I shouldn't have moved one of the warriors. Because, like, three in here doesn't really do a lot. Maybe I could have moved him out at the end. Or this guy out at the end or something. But it did make him catching the scatter harder. Like, hopefully, if he does recover, he'll just score this turn, then I can 2-1 grind him. That was the first Nurgle Warrior foul that I've seen. And it was pretty cool animation, wasn't it? I re-rolled that because I didn't want him standing and him one dicing me again, because he could Kaz him, couldn't he? So as lame as it was to use that re-roll. Look what happens when the TV's remotely fair. Unbelievable, Jeff. And also, I probably should have. I'd 1-9 that turn. That I 1-9 that block on that guy. I wanted to hand off to a Nurgle Warrior, because really, this is such an easy situation. I should have got a touchdown on these guys. I shouldn't have gone for it. But it, you know, I didn't want to. With him having one gutter runner, I didn't want to. I didn't want to go for that. Not ideal. It's good enough though, wasn't it? Good enough. Ducky Fago levels up. In an appropriate game for Ducky Fago to level up, a game absolutely smashing the fuck out of 11 man rats. So there you go. Pretty good. Definitely boring block first, but yeah, go block frenzy, mighty blow, claw piling on, and that is the route for Ducky Fagos. Because I think it's worth having an extra block guy, isn't it? A wrestler'd be okay. I think what I might do is, if I get a decent TV, get a, you know, go wrestle for the fourth Pestigo. But I definitely want a tackle pommer and a frenzy pommer. Oh, thank you, Ninzda. Could have done it before, so I wasn't phoned on TV down, but like, I don't know, it's just, so much of it comes down to TV matchups, doesn't it? Because if I was even TV with that dwarf guy, he wouldn't have stood a chance. But because he was phoned TV up, it was just horrible. Stay fantastic. What an easy match. But if he had a wizard, it would have been a lot dodgier, so he was unlucky to not have anything. Not have anything in the bank, or, you know, have got his coach, if he hadn't got those coaches and stuff. Right. I'll reroll a 3, might as well. I guess I shouldn't have rerolled 3 because I had 150k for a wizard. It was a bad reroll. Very bad reroll. Right. 26 AV breaks. Crazy. But I did lots of fouls, didn't I, as well? Being men's up lets you make lots of fouls, doesn't it? Ducky Fagos gets blockity block block block. Also, block lets you move with the stats, doesn't it? I like going block first on all of them. Oh, a double. He could go have a cheeky guarder, I guess. This one, he's definitely going dirty player. And because that one's on 10 as well, isn't he? So fucking hell. So this guy on 10 could go guard with block in mind for his second skill if he ever gets that far. Or he could just go block or wrestle. He's not going to take leap. Guard almost certainly is the choice, isn't it? I do wish I'd leveled up one of these two, because block on the warrior would basically be better than the block on the Pestigo. But, you know. Sneaky good. How much does this game cost? I don't know, it's probably about half price at the moment, or maybe even more off with the sales. So I don't know. Yeah, with frenzy you go down one path in development. Yeah, sure, Ducky. But you know, if he was to roll agility, then I could go away from frenzy, couldn't I? Whereas if I'd gone frenzy first, I couldn't. Like how I had to pass up on them AG4 and Mash Fagos, didn't I? Because 11 to 24 euros. Plus, if you've got the tabletop box set, which you won't have, you get an extra 50% off, so it can be quite cheap. I need to think about this because block is just going to be more useful probably. Because when you think about it, the rule of five is going to be these two and him and these two. These two are the guys blitzable on the outside, and this is the guy blitzable. So he's going to go on the LOS. Now, does he want to go on the LOS with guard? Not really. Would I want to put a warrior on the thing? Not really. So, happy New Year, Jaleel. Yep, and everybody else, whenever it is for you. Right, so it's getting there, isn't it? I need basically to win out from here, though. Five wins tomorrow, five wins the day after, and then could get up to 24-6-2, which would be maybe good enough. I don't know. I just wish I'd had more games close to TV. It's kind of fun, TWS 311. It's basically, it's equal parts fun and frustrating. It's the Blood Bowl 2 computer game is good, kind of, because it's Blood Bowl. Blood Bowl, the actual original game, is unbelievably the best game ever. But, you know, the computer thing, it's basically, it's if you can join a good league and get lucky and win all your games, it's a lot of fun. If you join a good league and do shit and lose all three games, then it's not very fun. Yeah, it's a funny old game. It is a funny old game. It is equal parts fun and unbelievably frustrating. It's a bit like poker, I guess, because you can make the right plays and lose and stuff like that. Yeah, 12-1-0 is the top team because Don Chump is actually... Oh, he's not the top necro. Fuck. Someone's overtaken him for top necro. Don Chump's necros are higher. But he's not qualifying with them. Thank you for the follow, Benvaro. So actually, his Nurgle are the best Nurgle. So yeah, 24-6-2 is the best Nurgle team at the moment. But, like, this 16-2-1, if he wins at 16-2-1, he goes 17-2-1 and goes above him. So I've almost got zero chance, actually. Almost got zero chance. Oh, yeah, Silver Titan, the lizards. Cool. Got to go something to beat World Sitar, though, haven't you? Oh, no, it's not World Sitar, sorry. It's Agent TBC 15-0. Holy shit. That's Oh, Necros. All right, you're the top Necro guy. Ah. So, yeah, my current record is garbage. It's 14-6-2. So I'd have to win 10 in a row just to equal Don Chump. I might be better just making a new team. To try and get the streak, because you know this streak 15-0 beats everything, doesn't it? So it is almost worth just starting a new I don't know, not Dark Elves or Wood Elves. A new non Dark Elf, non Wood Elf team and just trying to go 15-0. It seems easier than trying to go 12-1-0 with this team. I mean, the team is good. It's just down TV every time. Like, so many games have been down 300 odd TV. It's just fucking brutal. That's the thing that's made it hard. If I'd stuck with this team from game one, I would have had a much better record because I wouldn't have had the I don't think 15-0 is possible with Nurgle. No, I don't think so either. Tony plays poorly, but it'd be possible with, like, say, Undead or whatever. No, I just mean a fresh team. Any team except Dark Elves and Wood Elves. But a good team. I didn't mean literally any team. Norse or humans. Or whatever. Yeah, that's the thing. You start new teams and matching 300 TV down. So that means that on the last days, you're not getting the fresh team. So yeah, I should have totally stuck with this team. Well, not this team. A Nurgle team from the start. I should have just... The first one I started, even with a... You know, when I started two wins, two draws, whatever. I started with a draw. Okay, I shouldn't have started with a draw. I should have... I was going to make Ducky a wrestler. Yeah, I was going to make him a wrestler. But then I thought, fuck it, I'll make him a frenzier instead. Because I prefer frenzy to wrestle. Because I've got tackle on the Pestigo. That was the thing. If this Pestigo had rolled doubles for jump up, no, actually Chaos has got is the easiest record to catch. Funnily enough, in quite the turnaround from season one, where obviously I expected to be dominated by Chaos, you'd expect Chaos to do the worst in this format, and they have lived up to it. 18-2-3 is the best, so 13-1-1 Chaos would be top Chaos. So yeah, they're actually the worst team is Chaos. Isn't that crazy? Yeah, I'll just keep going with Tentalica and see how it goes in the end. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. So if I'd rolled a double for jump up on my killer, or if I'd taken Frenzy on my killer, then I would have gone Wrestle for Ducky Fago. But the thing is, my killer's not reliably going to make Legend, is he? So it's possible that he makes Legend, but you know, you never know. You've got to bank on 5 skills max, haven't you? You're unlikely to make Legend realistically. He should be getting his next one soon, hopefully Dodge. Yeah, and Chaos have it fucking... Hello, Goliath. Yeah, and it's just hard starting a new team right now. So what I should have done was I should have stuck with the first Nurgle team that I made, Nurgle Champions or whatever, and just stuck with them. And through the hard times, whatever I got for them, I've deleted them already. But whatever bad start I'd got, I should have tried to go through with them. I mean, like, this got a bit of a bad start, didn't it? 2 wins, 2 draws. But if I'd just stuck with them instead of starting Tentalica, maybe those extra 4 games would have come into it. And the earlier the better, isn't it? That's 100 star player points in 15 games. It does seem impossible, doesn't it? It does seem impossible. But I mean, I could play more because they could get concessions and stuff and get the extra MVPs. So it's possible, but yeah. And I could make it 15. Yeah, I don't know, he's made a few, hasn't he? He's made a lot of Lupak's made a lot of teams to try to catch the 2-year stop pot. I mean, the old system was much better. The thing is, the old system was much better for people like Lupak, wasn't it? You know, and me if I wanted. But Lupak actually likes playing the same team over and over again. So it was perfect for him, the old one. But it was perfect for me. I mean, there's no doubt if I wanted to qualify in the first season, I would have done. With this one, it's not easy, isn't it? No matter how good you are, even if I was the best player in the world by a mile, it still comes down to the matchups and everything, and whether you get decent matchups and what have you. I did indeed Emperor Augustus. So if I just stuck with one team, then if I just stuck with the first team that got the draw in the first 3 games, I would have been all right. 17-2-0 would place pretty fucking high. Kurgo. Probably higher than this would. Yeah, to be fair. But then this team's actually good now, and you know, I could bosh out another lot of games potentially, so we'll see. Anyway, I'm calling it a day for now, because I'm gonna play some GTA, and so I'm not gonna stream it because I'm just gonna be doing boring shit. And yeah, so there you go. I'm a bit tired as well. So thank you. No, do you know what? Hello. Yeah, no, I don't think so. I'm going to give up. If I get a loss, Kurgle, if I get another loss, I'm giving up. If I get anything that isn't a win from here, I'm giving up, because there's so little time. There's basically 3 more days to qualify. And plus, I want to play a bit of GTA and stuff as well. So yeah, thanks for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, and stay fantastic.